फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वेरियस फेसर डिजाइंस। प्रॉपर नॉलेज ऑफ एनाटॉमी ऑफ डेंजर बियरिंग एरियाज एंड द यूज ऑफ कस्टम ट्रे विद अ प्रॉपर फेसर डिजाइन एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशन ड्यूरिंग इंप्रेशन मेकिंग इज एट मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर स्टेबल एंड रिटेन डी प्रोसेसेस दैट इज इन हार्मोनी विद सराउंडिंग एंड अंडरलाइन टिश्यूज। सो द design of a spacer is very much important in the field of cross surroundings. Coming to the classification of spacer designs, first one is full spacer. It is made to cover the whole residual ridge except posterior parietal seal area in the maxilla and buccal shelf and the retromyelohyoid area in the mandible. So here this is the full spacer and thus providing space for impression material. Okay, then next one is the partial spacers. Based on clinical needs, it is made to cover specific areas only, like T-shaped and I-shaped spacer. Okay, next one is the spacers with tissue stoppers. Tissue stoppers are windows which are made bilaterally at the canine and the molar region, mostly 2 mm in width, and they help in proper vertical seating of the impression tray and control the thickness of the impression material. So these are the classification of spacer designs, that is full spacer, partial spacer and spacer with tissue stops. Okay. So next one is the materials used for making spacers. First one is the Tin foil, as recommended by Roy Mac Gregory in the region of incisive papilla and mid-parietal raphe. So this is tin foil. Okay. Next one is the casting wax, as recommended by Neil, in thickness of 0.9 mm to be adapted all over except PPSA. Okay, PPSA except all other areas. That is casting wax according to Neil. Next is or non-asbestos ring liner or wet ring liner. It is here. It is used. Shellac is used for custom tray fabrication. Next one is the base plate wax. It is used as a spacer mostly when acrylic resin is used for custom tray fabrication. So, mostly used material for making spacer is the base plate wax. Okay. Coming to the thickness of wax spacer. Spacer for completely or partially dangerous cases are generally 1 to 3 mm thick. But the thickness depends on type of impression material used for making secondary impressions and the demand of the clinical situation. So first one is 2 mm spacer with tissue stops, 0.5 mm spacer. And it is used when impression plaster or zinc oxide original is being used for making impression in cases of non-undercut ridges. Second one is 3 mm spacer with tissue stops. Here used with alginate for non-undercut and undercut ridges. Third one is 1.5 mm spacer with tissue stops. Used with polysulfide elastomeric impression material for undercut or non-undercut ridges. Then 3 mm spacer used with silicones for undercut and non-undercut ridges. And fifth one is non-specified. In cases of different clinical situations and demands, spacer thickness and design varies, like for displaceable tissues. So these are the various thickness of wax space. In this table, it represents various spacer design and thickness for various impression materials. So coming to some clinical situations, first one is non-undercut ridges. The impression plaster as well as zinc oxide original is used as impression material. And the spacer design and thickness is 2 mm spacer with tissue stops and 0.5 mm spacer. Non-undercut and undercut ridges, alginate, elastomeric impression materials like polysulfide and silicones are used. For alginate, it is 3 mm spacer with tissue stops. And for polysulfide, it is 1.5 mm spacer with tissue stops. And for silicones, 3 mm spacer. Then displaceable tissues. Zinc oxide original paste, impression plaster and various elastomers are used. as the impression material, and the spacer design and thickness variable based on clinical situation. So this is about the summarized version of spacer design and thickness for various clinical situations. So the next one is tissue stops. They are to be placed strategically. They provide even thickness of the impression materials in the first impression. So here the tissue stops, which are made by removing the wax at 45 degree angulation, okay, to the occlusal surface, and which will have a tripod or quadrangular arrangement on the arch. This provides stability to the tray and which will help the help to center the tray during the insertion. Okay. So coming to the various spacer designs. First one is Boucher spacer design for maxillary arch and the mandibular arch. Based on selective pressure technique, advocated the placement of 1 mm base plate wax on the entire base seat area except PPSA. According to him, PPSA will act as guiding stop to position the tray properly during the impression procedures. He also advocated the placement of escape holes with number 6 round burr in the parietal region, and 1 mm thick base plate wax covers the mandibular ridge except buccal shelf area and the retromolar pad. So this is the Boucher spacer design for maxillary and mandibular arch. So coming to the Morrow, Red and Rhodes spacer design for the maxillary arch. Based on minimal pressure technique, recommend blocking out undercut areas with wax and then adapting the full wax spacer 2 mm short of resin special tray border all over. Then they recommend placement of 3 tissue stops 4 into 4 mm equidistant from each other. That is Morrow, Red and Rhodes spacer design for maxillary arch. Coming to JJ Shady's spacer design for maxillary and mandibular arch. Here, based on minimal pressure technique, it recommends adaptation of a layer of base plate wax over the whole area outlined for the tray, even in PPSA. Okay. And he recommends the placement of 4 tissue stops, 2 mm in width, located in molar and cuspid regions, which should extend from parietal aspect of the ridge to the mucobuccal fold, and 1 vent hole in the incisive papillar region before making the final impression with metallic oxide impression material. So here it is the maxillary arch and this is the mandibular arch design. Okay, JJ Shary's spacer design. Coming to Bernard and Levin spacer design for maxillary arch. Here it is also based on selective pressure technique. Recommends a layer of pink base plate wax about 2 mm thick. Attached to the areas of cast, usually have the areas of softer tissues. And he recommends the placement of wax spacer all around except the posterior part of the patch, which according to him are at high angles to the occlusal force. Next one is the Halperin spacer design for maxillary and mandibular arch. Here he recommended the custom tray with peripheral relief. Okay. He suggested that the custom trays be provided with 1 mm thick wax relief over the peripheral extensions and buccal slope regions of tray including PPSA. And this provides the internal finish line that forms the butt joint of the compound to the tray after border molding is completed. No secondary wash impression is needed as tray surface and border molded areas act as final impression surface. Master cast is directly poured into the border molded trays without using wash impression. So this is the Halperin spacer design for maxillary and mandibular arch. Coming to McGregor design, that is Roy McGregor's spacer design for maxillary arch. Here it is also based on selective pressure technique. That recommends the placement of sheet of metal foil in the region of incisive papilla and the mid-patent raphe. Okay. Coming to the Neil spacer design for maxillary arch. Here he recommends the adaptation of 0.9 mm casting wax all over except PPSA. Okay, here he used casting wax except PPSA. Okay, here it is Sheldon's phaser design for the maxillary arch. Next one is Sun Shetty's phaser design for maxillary arch. Here he used the technique in which thin sheet of wax, that is 0.4 mm major connector wax, which is required to be placed in all areas except PPSA. Okay. As this area needs to be compressed during border molding procedures. 1.5 mm thick layer of modeling wax is applied onto the top of already adapted wax sheet. Okay. And the modeling wax is removed in the region of crest of alveolar ridge and the horizontal plate. So, from the horizontal plate as well as the crest of the alveolar ridge, the modeling wax is removed in this picture as in, okay, as these are the stress bearing areas. Okay, so he removed the modeling wax in the region of stress bearing areas like crest of alveolar ridge and the horizontal palate. According to Smith design, that is Dale E. Smith's phaser design for maxillary arch, he used 1 mm thick base plate wax covers the ridge and the mid-peritoneal raphe. Okay, mid-peritoneal raphe and the ridge is covered. Two tissue stops, each at the canine region and exposed heart palate. Okay, heart palate is exposed. Help in proper vertical seating of the tray and control the thickness of impression material. Coming to the miscellaneous design for maxillary and mandibular arch. Here, based on the minimal pressure technique, 1 mm base plate wax is placed over the basal area except right and left posterior heart palate. And 4 tissue stoppers, each at canine and the molar regions, and the exposed areas act as stoppers. And the material of choice is rubber. Coming to the miscellaneous design for the mandibular arch, here it is based on selective pressure technique. 1 mm thick base plate wax is placed over the anterior alveolar ridge except at the retromolar pad area. Tissue stops are placed each at canine region bilaterally. Full coverage with tissue stops provide uniform thickness of the impression material. Coming to the eye spacer and teeth spacer in maxillary and mandibular arch. So, eye spacer design for maxillary arch, it's based on selective pressure technique. It covers the incisive papilla and the mid-peritoneal raphe when it is prominent. Okay. This is T-spacer designed for maxillary and mandibular arch. T-spacer covers the anterior alveolar ridge in maxilla when it is resorbed and flabby. If it is resorbed and flabby, T-spacers are used. It is based on selective pressure technique. It also covers the prominent incisive papilla, rugae and mid-peritoneal raphe, and the exposed areas act as stoppers. Partial spacer designs in the mandible, which cover only the anterior residual alveolar ridge when it is atrophic, resorbed or flabby. This is based on selective pressure technique and the spacer placed on relieving areas and the exposed areas act as stoppers. Okay, so the exposed areas act as stoppers. That is all about the various spacer designs for complete denture fabrication. Thanks for watching. Please do share and subscribe for more videos. Thank you.